Good afternoon on Wednesday the 24th of May. I must say, I think it's rather hot this week for those who are having to sit their exams, but hopefully it's not putting anyone off. Our opening prayer. As our evening prayer rises before you, O God, so may your mercy come down upon us to cleanse our hearts and set us free to sing your praise, now and forever. Amen. May this evening be holy, good and peaceful. Amen. Today's readings are Psalm 46 and Ephesians chapter 5, verses 15 to 20. Musical taste is a very personal thing, and whether a piece of music or a song is good or not can be a hotly debated issue. In churches, there has been discussions for years about what is an appropriate musical style. And when people speak of a modern hymn or Christian song, it's usually been written well over 10 years ago. Also, people who quickly pick up tunes they hear in everyday life somehow seem to lose this ability once they walk into a church building. We all have our favourite hymns and Christian songs. I try not to make it too obvious what mine are by selecting a wide variety of musical style for our services. And even though many of these tunes are inspirational, it's the words which are really important to me. Our singing is not an expression of theology. It's an act of praise and worship to God. It's how we draw closer to Him and His throne room. When writing to the Ephesians, St. Paul reminds us that there is much for which we should be praising God. And this praise should link into how we live our lives, including our lives being full of the Holy Spirit. In Psalm 46, the biblical hymn writer speaks about how the nations are in uproar, something which sadly we are all too familiar with in various ways. But despite the distress this causes, we have the assurance through the biblical hymn writer that the Lord Almighty is with us. As you've listened so far, you'll have picked up that there is a theme of Christian music running through my thoughts today. And this is because today is when we give thanks for the life and ministry of John and Charles Wesley, who are described as evangelists and hymn writers. I always think of John Wesley as the preacher, perhaps because of the number of blue plaques I've come across around the country, each of them positioned in a place where he preached and made a significant difference for the people who listened to him. As for Charles Wesley, I associate him as the hymn writer who wrote many of our favourite hymns, including Love Divine. The end of verse 6 of this hymn says, "Pray and praise thee without ceasing, glory in thy perfect love." I think that Ephesians chapter 5 verse 20 sums up the ministry of the Wesley brothers as it says, "Always give thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen." I commented how many blue plaques I've seen in various places in local communities where John Wesley preached. And that's why today I think it's appropriate to pray our community prayer. Loving Lord, We thank you that you are already everywhere. We pray for the areas of Mill Hill, Gallagher, Bank Top and Witten. We think of everyone who lives in these areas, all who work there, and those who pass through them during their daily lives. We ask that you give us the eyes to see your vision for these places. Amen. For our prayer points today, pray that our lives are acts of true worship to God. Give thanks for music and the pleasure it brings. And pray that we use our God-given talents to God's glory. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. The warm light evenings mean that there's still plenty of time, maybe to go for a walk or do a bit of gardening, even after a meal. So I hope that you manage to fit something like that in. And our blessing for today. God the Father who created you, strengthen you. God the Son who redeemed you, support you. God the Holy Spirit who guides you, direct you. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son and Holy Spirit, be with you and your family and friends today and evermore.